Tons of truth, and there's lots of truth, but it can't come at the expense of mercy, can't come at the expense of faith, it can't come at the expense of my foundation, your foundation, amen? In the city of Mara, worrying is like walking around with an umbrella waiting for it to rain. We expect the worst. I mean, everything's okay here, but the minute I walk out these doors, ain't no telling what's gonna happen. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, what? I mean, there's always something lurking around the corner, isn't there? Stay out of the city of Marath, man. Whew. I would just stay out of that place. Because it's only going to cause confusion. Shouldn't we assume the best? If we trust God, like, shouldn't we assume the best and think the best? And like, doesn't the Bible talk about that also? And again, we're talking about people. People. Think the best of people. Assume the best of people and believe that God's working in their life. Church. They that wait upon the Lord. How do you get stronger? I got to wait on the Lord, church. You got to wait on the Lord. Everybody got to wait on the Lord. He's doing the work, but you do have to wait on him. But then I get stronger. What happened to the house of David? It waxed stronger and stronger. And then what happened to Saul's house? Well, it waxed weaker and weaker. The Christ in me gets stronger and stronger, and then the Saul in me gets weaker and weaker. It takes time. But God does that. He'll revitalize and renew the spirit of Christ in you, and it'll get stronger and stronger. And then you realize Saul gets weaker and weaker. And you know what? You're not looking to kill David anymore. Because you understand. Because now I'm no longer a stranger to God, but I am a stranger with God. David said, I am a stranger with thee. But he was a stranger for those. He was a stranger to Saul. Why? Because Saul didn't know that his name was written on a star in heaven. He thought his name. Let me write my name. Because we want the Hollywood Walk of Fame. We want our star on the earth here. I get that. So we all do. You gotta let go of that one though. You can't live in this state of duality. You can't have your star here and your star there. Can I get an amen? Amen. You gotta let go of the star here because that's the greatest star. And this star is going away anyway. It's not even a real star, church. Come on now. The city of Lachish, we got to win at all cost. And of course, there's relationships lying in the rubble. But I've won. I don't know what you've won. There's lots of things. There's lots of definitions of winning. But if your relationships are lying in rubble, I say you haven't won a thing. Yea, doubtless, I count all things as loss compared to the excellency and the knowledge of Christ Jesus, my Lord. Whom I've suffered the loss of all things, that I may win Christ. And what did he count them as? Dung. Whatever I've lost, it was garbage anyway. The star on the Walk of Fame, it was garbage anyway. Whatever I have today, it's worthless compared to winning Christ. It's Christ, church. And then Akzib, I like this quote, because this is actually from Helen Keller. Happiness. True happiness is not attained through self-gratification, but through fidelity to a worthy purpose. Now, let me ask you this, church. How is it, Helen Keller, you guys know the story of Helen Keller. She was blind and deaf. How is somebody that's blind and deaf, how do they know what the true definition of happiness is? Could it be because the only happiness she could find was within herself, and she actually found it? You mean, so my happiness is not based on my external circumstances, what I hear and what I see? Because I don't know if you're like me, church. I say if I get this, I'll be happy then. You know what happens when I get it? Well, I'll really be happy when I get this. No. I mean, really, I know I'll be happy if I... If this happens, then I'll be happy. Or sometimes it's not about what we have. If I can get rid of this, I'll be happy. What might we be getting rid of? Yeah, usually people. If Joey wasn't fighting, if Joey would just quit, then I would have the window office. If I could just remove this person from my life, I'd be happy. And usually it's not the one at work, it's usually the one at the dinner table. Mike, if Mike would just step back, I could have a little more vittles on the table. But I get the vittles on the table, church, and I'm not happy. You see, happiness is never going to be found outside of Christ. Happiness is never based on external. It's internal. It's the Christ inside of you. Ecclesiastes talks about this, right? It's chasing the wind. You can't be. It's not based on your external circumstances, whether you have something or whether you think you've got to remove something. No. You're not. That's not true happiness. Amen? And we're deceived by that because we think if we chase it, we're gonna be happy. Or if we get rid of it, we're going to be happy. We're deceived. We're confused about the true happiness. Amen? So what is our purpose? Helen Keller talked about our purpose. This is the words of Solomon. But now thy Lord, my God, hath given me rest on every side, so that there is neither adversary nor evil occurrent. And behold, I purpose to build a house unto the name of my God, as the Lord spake unto David, my father, saying, thy son, whom I will set upon the throne in thy room, he shall build the house upon my name. What's our purpose? It is to build the church. Amen. How many churches? Just like God says, he's the author of all of the churches. That's what we do. That's our purpose. We can't lose sight of that. We can't lose sight of who we are. And we got to build the church. And I love it because David, remember, David couldn't build it. And David's a picture of Christ. What did he do? He went to war. What did Jesus Christ do? He went to war. He went to war for your soul. And he won the fight, church, because I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ. Amen? Amen. Master worship team, if they can come. Church, we can't build God's house if we think we got enemies or we got evil thoughts of others. Because my Bible says that he didn't have not one adversary nor one evil occurrent. And that's when he started building the church. Once I can get rid of all my enemies, and the enemies are only inside of my head, evil thoughts are only inside of my head, when I get rid of them, I can start building the church and realize it's a big church and it's a big God and he loves us all. Amen? Why don't you stand while we close out?